This is Tridip and you are watching Learn with Tridip.
Hey, hi guys. So today I will show you a very interesting presentation. So there is a software called Prezi. I think nowadays everybody knows about the software, which is an online version presentation tool that gives fantastic and very innovative zoom slide function, where each section is highlighted in a smooth zoom way. And they have shown in their website some fantastic examples, which is very innovative at the same time very interesting. Till now people has always complained that Microsoft PowerPoint presentation does not have something like this, and people always used to say that Prezi is much better than PowerPoint and all these things. Well, I don't want to go into the debate whether Prezi is much better than PowerPoint or PowerPoint is much better than Prezi, but definitely the Microsoft version of the software, that is PowerPoint, is way too user friendly for me, and it has been in the industry for a number of years, and so most of the people are very much used to using PowerPoint presentation. So what I will teach in this particular episode of Learn with Tridip is that I will show how we can use PowerPoint presentations to create Prezi style animated, zoom animated movement in PowerPoint itself. And not only that, if you scroll in Google, if you search in Google of Prezi, you will see there are loads of presentations that people have already created in using PowerPoint. And if you search, that the major funny part is that most of the presentations that you see in PowerPoint, they are claiming Prezi style presentation in PowerPoint. So yes, in PowerPoint 365 nowadays, you can create fantastic animated, zoom animated slides, much like Prezi and better than that maybe to certain extent, which is a really, really great things that we can now present our own presentations in PowerPoint in a much more advanced Prezi style. So if you see, there are a lot of presentations by OneSkill PowerPoint. They have shown how Prezi can actually be done in PowerPoint.
Hello ladies and gentlemen, my name is OneSkill, and in today's video I will show you how you can create a Prezi style PowerPoint presentation. Let's go.
So in today's example, I will teach you the three most wonderful options now PowerPoint have in Microsoft PowerPoint is the zoom function. Where do you get the zoom function? Okay, here it is. So when you go to insert, you will have a zoom option. This is the most powerful information that you can have in PowerPoint nowadays. And many of the people, they actually don't know how to use zoom and what a hidden treasure that zoom has in itself, I can show you in this particular presentation. So concentrate and see each step by step how I introduce zoom. There are three features in zoom. I will cover one after another. One is the summary zoom, one is a section zoom, and one is a slide zoom. While the slide zoom zooms content from one slide to the other, the section zoom takes you from one section to the other and brings you back to the main slide, and summary zoom actually is a congregation of 2-3 slides in one slide, and it helps you zoom within a slide as a summary screen slide. So I will take you to the processes. I have already created certain things for you. I will first give examples of it, and then I will try to take you through the process how you can actually create zoom effects like Prezi, better than that, in Microsoft PowerPoint. So here we go. So if we see in the slide 6, which is a slider zoom, I will show you the example. So if I click on this orange, you can see we are going to the next section. I click it back, it goes back. I click again in the yellow box, which is a section. It shows the subsections. I read all those things and I click back. It goes back to the menu. And again, if I click on the green one, it shows the subsections and goes back. So this is called slide zoom. If you see, the first slide is a trigger slide, which has three definite zoom trigger points, and these are the three slides that it takes you to. The second one I will show you, basically it is more like a summary zoom, where this particular slide actually gives you the summary of the three slides that we can navigate into. So if I just click on the play, I can show you that when I click on this, this particular summary opens up, click it back, it goes inside, goes to the next option, click it, it zooms that section, and the third one. So I will now show you another fantastic option of PowerPoint, which is the section zoom, but I will do with another new and awesome transition that PowerPoint has introduced called the morph transition. So the morph transition over here that you find in the latest version of Office 365 is a fantastic animation tool which has been very less used by people because many of the people don't know that what morph can do. I will take you to much more detailed explanation of morph in a separate video which I will create for you, but for this particular example I will only touch and go morph, and I will show some features of morph and I will keep it like that. In detail I will show how what morph can do, how they can do fantastic animation in a next video that coming up in Learn with Tridib. So without much ado, let's start the section zoom with morph. Similarly, so like the other two sections, if I go to precaution, you will see that when I click on this section, it zooms in with the same video at the back playing. I click on the precaution section again, and this section comes up. I click back, it goes back to the same section. And if I click on the end section, it will take to the end of the slide. So what is happening basically, when I click on precaution, a slide zoom happens and takes you to the next section. I click it again, see the animation happens. Over here I have a video which plays immediately as the slide opens. I have three images and text which came animated in. That can also be done very easily. I click and it goes back again. Similarly, for the first block also, if I click on it, it opens up. I click it more, it is basically a double zoom that is happening. I zoom to the first section, again I click, I go back to the I go to the next zoom section. So over here also you can see, as soon as the slide opens, I see this video playing. I have this animation. If you see, if you notice very carefully, you will see that the animation happened like a text morph. And I click, it goes back. I click on the end section, the PowerPoint ends. So now let me take you through each and every section, and I will show you how these things can be easily done with PowerPoint. So first I will take you through the slider zoom section. Let me first create a new presentation. So for the speed of the presentation, I will not create each and every object, but I will copy paste from the existing slides so that we can save on time. So first I will take these three slides, I will copy it, open the presentation where we want to do it, and we paste it. We also copy the first slide and paste it there also. But what I will do, I will delete these blocks for you. Now what I will do, I will click on insert, click on zoom and say slide zoom. What I will do, I will select these three slides and insert. So what has happened now, these three slides have now got integrated in my first slide. So if you see that it is absolutely opaque and the design is getting hampered, so I will just go to the zoom tool and say zoom background, it becomes transparent. See, okay. Now I don't want these three slides to be seen in my design. I will change their icon. How do I do it? See, the three blocks are now transparent. I can see the end of the arrows over here, but I don't like these particular icons over there. Nevertheless, this still works. How it works? Let's see. I will just play this thing and you will see when I click on this, it opens up. I click, it goes to the next one. I click, it goes to the next one. And I click back, it goes and ends. The reason is behind that in this, if you go to zoom tools and go to the zoom tool section, you will see the return to zoom is not checked. That means the flow will go to the next flow and next. It is in a sequence manner from 1 to 2 to 3. But I don't want that. I want in each click, I have to return to the main zoom. So similarly, what I will do, I will go and click return to zoom. I will check this box on. You will see now if I play, when I click, it zooms in, click, zoom out, click, zoom in, click, zoom out, click, zoom in, click, zoom out. Okay, so this is exactly what we expected. But still, I am not happy with these icons popping up over here. So what should I do? What you can do, you can replace these icons or these hierarchical maps with your own icon. It can be anything. It can be a picture, it can be any shape, anything. So right now for our use, our first use, I have already created some icons which I will replace with this. How do I do it? I will go to again the zoom tools and I will go and click the change image and I go on click on change image. So I go to this folder where I have already created some images. These images are directly saved from PowerPoint as PNGs. Instead of these shapes, you can also use any image to replace these things. This is totally up to you. So for our sake, to make it more faster, I will click and select the orange ball for this first section. See, it is replaced. For the yellow one, I will go and again do the same thing, change image, scroll down, click on the yellow ball, it is replaced again, click on the green one, go to change image and change it to the green ball. We are all set, we are done. So now if I just select the thing, you will see that this works perfectly as we expected. And don't you think it is super fast in movement and very, very smooth? So that's the first part of our slide zoom section. The second part, I will again do the same thing. So now I will show you summary zoom or summary section zoom. I will click and select these three sections. I will go to our section and paste it. And I will also take a blank screen. So now what I will do in the blank screen, it can be any design screen of yours where you can place these three other summary sections. I will just click on this and I will go to zoom again, click on summary zoom instead of slide zoom. Now see what happens. It again gives me the option to select three slides and I say insert. What happens in this, if you see, it has created a summary of three slides over here. You have not done anything great. It has helped you in creating the summary slide in one go, in one click. What now we have to do? If we are not happy with these icons, we can change it. But before that, we have to first see whether it is working or not. Again, I click on slideshow. I go to this section, click, it zooms, the section zooms. I click on this, the section zooms. I click on this, the section zooms. So this is a summary section which can zoom to eternity and zoom back. Isn't this awesome? Don't you think that we can create fantastic stuffs with only these zoom options? Well, Prezi has shown the way, but PowerPoint can actually help you to get this thing done very, very easily in just one or two clicks, and you can create fantastic stuff out of the zoom tools. So again, if you don't like these icons, as usual, I can just go to the zoom tools, go to change image, and for the betterment of our things and make things faster, I have already created these rectangles. I can just change these shapes. Again, you can change it with images as well. So there is no problem in that. And you can place it in the holder that it has created already. Right? Looks great. Let us check it again. Wow, this works perfectly, right? Great. So I think we have learned something awesome, and we can definitely take it to the next level and create fantastic stuff out of it. This last one is the section zoom that I will show you with obviously some rich animation and video integration. Also, as I told, as a bonus, I will show you what Morph can do, so that you can also use a lot of stuffs using the Morph transition that is very new in the Office 365. Okay, so without much ado, let's hit back to the old animation that I have showed you just now. So let's see what it has. It has a background video of COVID-19 virus. So you can get a lot of these free videos from texels.com, a very nice website where you get a lot of free stuffs that you can use it in your presentations. Let me show you. Pexels.com is a fantastic free site from which you can actually see videos, photographs, whatever you want. So yeah, I checked for coronavirus and I also checked for videos. See, there are a hell lot of videos that are there. I picked up many from here since they are free to use for your presentations, which are in a personal way. They are very, very high quality and absolutely wonderful, very nicely cinematographed and videographed by professionals. So I, for this particular video's sake, I have already saved a lot of videos in this folder. So yeah, this is your background video, which you can actually get from thepixels.com. What I have also done, I have researched a lot of data about the impact of coronavirus, what are the precautions, the inception of coronavirus, the spread, and the social impact of the virus in social as well as business and personal life. So you can do a lot of research nowadays. These all the informations in this website are authentic because they are taken from WHO website and Wikipedia. So most of the informations are correct as per the date that I have mentioned in the video. So what I have done, I have taken this video. Cool. I can also take it second time. I can just copy it and I can show you how these things happens, or I can show it over here itself. So this video comes over here. I go to the playback. I want this video to automatically play in the background. So loop until stopped is turned on, rewind after playing is turned on, so that it goes and again from the first frame and plays again, and start is automatically. That means when this particular screen starts, the video will play automatically without any clicks required. Also, what I have done, I have created these sliders. So these sliders are created in the way I have used. If you see, there are, you can insert a lot of icons default that comes with PowerPoint. I have used only those icons. The fonts are there from the normal fonts, and this is again three text blocks that I have created. So I have highlighted these stuffs, so many confirmed cases. This is as per the end of May. So it changes, the data might change when the presentation actually goes live, and how many countries affected, how many confirmed deaths and all these things. In the second slide, I changed it a bit. So I introduced a video. This is again taken from pixels.com. If you play, if you see that the video plays and shows the countries and the continents that are affected by this deadly virus. You can, by default, this video was quite big, in the sense it was of a longer time frame. You can definitely go to playback, you go to video trim, and you can cut. If you see, this area I have already cut. The best part of PowerPoint is that even if you trim the video is not deleted. That portion of the video is not deleted. You can always go back and retrim the video as per your use. You can trim it shorter, you can trim it again in a bigger time span. So since I have already trimmed it, I cancel it and move it to the screen. Similarly, if you see inception and spread, so what are these things? So basically, these are sections that you can define. How do you define a section? It's very simple. You create a slide. Say for example, I create a slide and I click just below, just above it, and say section. Add a section, and you can say thank you. So this section becomes a thank you. So after the end section, you can just move to the thank you section. So I just write a thank you. And this becomes your thank you section that can come after the end of the video. So for the time being, I am deleting the section. So now, as I told you, this is a section zoom. So this zoom will happen between these sections. So we have four sections because we have four menu items, right? So section 1 is inception and spread. Section 2 is social impact. It is really doesn't matter whether you have the precaution first or the social impact first. Based on the name, it will jump. So that's not at all a problem. You can also move it up and down as per your wish. You click on precaution. So you have the precaution section over there. You have the social impact over there. You have the subsections. If you know that in the video, I have shown that there are subsections in the section called social impact. We have three sections like education impact, business impact, and psychological impact. Similarly, we have subsections like education, business, psychological. Okay, so great. So once we have set up our sections and subsections, now it is very easy to create. So I will just show you some of the animations that I have done. So if you see, if I go to slide number 17 and 18, you will see how the animation happens. So you saw that the text animated or morphed to a different text, right? How we achieved this? Nothing fancy, nothing extraordinary we are doing over here. We just have to select these two slides, go to transitions and say morph. Once we say morph, the transition happens. Since it is a sequence from the first one, I kept the original one without a transition so that it happens faster. And the second one, I have kept a morph where the text is morphing as well as the elements of the slide is also morphing. In the sense, they are animating. How they are animating? I have selected over here and have checked characters. So you have seen that the text of the first characters, first slides, the text changes to the second text in a much more animated way, which is more like a text morph animation. Also, if you see in slide 20, I have kept a morph, but over here, what happens when I move from 19 to 20? It animates the elements of these particular slide animates, right? So here it is. So from first to second, it animates. Believe me, I have not done any animation. I have just used the morph and it did the trick. There is no line animation. There is no specific animation timing that I have used. It is just simple morph. Okay, so now we know how these things has been settled. So every section has two parts, because if you are in one level of user movement, if you have two level of user movement, then you have more slides, right? Now I go to the slide number 16, and over here I did the same thing that I did for other Zoom functionalities. I went and simply inserted Zoom and actually selected section Zoom this time. Once I click on section Zoom, I just had to select from this section to this section, and my job was done. So each and every time I just need to select which section I need, and my job is done. So for every section I selected the, say for example, the inception, I selected the two sections. For social impact, I selected this entire range. For precaution, I selected these two, and for end, I selected this slide. Simple. And as usual, they came with the slide which I can always replace. Say for example, I had this education impact slide in slide number 22 with all this text and this image. The education slide came up in this menu. It was looking ugly, so I had the option to go over here, go to Zoom tools and click on change image, and I selected the education impact from here. Similarly, I did the same thing for business impact and psychological impact, and I am done. So this is the long and short of it. So say for example, if I just select all of them, and go to our new example and paste it over here, you will see the sections are not there. So we have to create the sections over here and name it. Say I again name it precaution. I click and name it add social impact. Again I go back and select the inception part. Paste it and again add a section called inception. So now I can just click a blank slide and I can add Zoom, section Zoom over here. Once I click on section Zoom, it asks me to select the sections. I insert them. If you see now, I have three sections, right? Looks awesome. I have to just go and play it. So I click on precaution. I go to the precaution section. The precaution animation plays. Lovely, isn't it? I click on precaution, again precautions goes in. I click on inception, the inception animation happens, and I click it again, the section animation happens. I click on social impact. The social impact animation happens. Okay, so you can see the links over here are not showing because I have not copied those slides over here. So now simple, you can, as I have shown, you can just insert any video at the back. You can just go to the video from file. Say I take up the same video that I have shown in the example, nothing new, click and send to back. Oh, it looks so dirty, right? It doesn't look so nice because it is white in color. So I can do one thing, I can go to zoom and say zoom background. So you see it becomes a transparent again. Zoom background, it becomes transparent. Zoom background, it becomes transparent. Okay, so that's it. That's all, folks. Isn't it wonderful? And it gives you some great idea what you can achieve through Zoom. And don't forget the wonderful tool that PowerPoint 365 or Office 365 has now given you is the Morph tool. In the next video, I will definitely show you how Morph can help you in creating awesome 2D and 3D videos. So till then, goodbye. If you really like the channel, please subscribe to it and don't forget to hit the bell icon. If you really like this video, please like, share and comment. I will feel great and it gives me motivation to create wonderful new videos. Bye-bye.